Hello students, welcome to the e-learning class of Organization of Commerce and Management of Standard 12 Gujarat Board, Chapter 1 Nature and Significance of Management, Part 9. Our today's topic is Functional Area of Management. To manage the business, many important functions are to be done. As per these functions, we will learn the below given functional areas of management, that is marketing management, human resource management, financial management and production management. Now, what is the function of all these areas of management? As in business, goods are to be produced according to the demand of the customers, and to know the demand, market research or survey is to be done. It is the function of marketing management to get the information regarding the market, that what is the taste and preference of customers and what is the demand of the particular goods produced by the company. The financial management arranges the finance for the business and tackles with the related matters of production of goods according to the needs and demand of the customers. And above all, we need the employees who make all the efforts of business successful by implementing the research done by market and finance arranged by the financial marketing management. So to arrange the human resource to perform all these functions is the function of human resource management. Now let us today discuss about marketing management in detail. In a broader sense, marketing management is the activity. Its function is to provide goods and services to the customer from the producer, and it includes the exchange of goods with money, as it is an economic activity, and to do the market research, distributive methods, sales promotion, storage, insurance, etc. is also the function of marketing management. The process of marketing management is firstly the research about the demand, taste and preference of the customers and provide the information to the business. Then their information is used to produce the goods or services, and finally it is made available to the customers or users. Thus, the needs of the customers are satisfied as the product is according to their needs. More focus is given on maximum utilization of resources and profitability of business unit or organization. The main aim of marketing management is to create demand for goods and services, whether it be by research and innovation of the product or by sales promotion. The main elements of market research are goods or services, physical distribution policy, price policy, increase in sales, packaging, etc. As this all elements attract the customers. Let us now discuss about the functions of marketing management. It is considered as 4 P's, that is product, price, place, that is distribution and promotion. First is product or product mix. For the growth and development of the business, the product needs innovation from time to time. So decision regarding innovation or development of new product is done by marketing management. So the decisions like appearance, color, shape, size, weight, print, packaging, guarantee of work, after sales services, variety of product, etc. are taken by the marketing management. Second is price. In modern times, customers demand high quality goods at reasonable price. Therefore, price is the important factor. If the price is too high, then it will be least selling product and ultimately the profit will be low. So while deciding price, sales policy, credit policy, policy regarding discount, wholesale or retail sale, and also commission of the mediators such as agents, etc. are also considered. Third is distribution. It includes the decisions like which type of distribution should be done to earn maximum profit. As the distribution channel will be small, the mediators will be less. Then the expenses will be low, and as the expenses will be low, the profit will be high. Therefore, decisions like direct selling through wholesaler, retailers, agents, as well as problems related to transportation, etc., are taken by marketing management. Distribution mix is related to the size and scope of a business unit. Last is promotion. Due to promotion, there is a remarkable increase in sales, as it includes advertisement, publicity, selling through salesmen, ways to attract customers and traders, as the customers and traders will know the quality of product and importance, they will be more attracted to buy the product, and many a times samples are also distributed so that people can know the specialty of the product. Though all these promotion mix is expenses, but due to these expenses there is large increase in sales, which is highly profitable. So students, today we had discussed about marketing management, and in our last part we will discuss about human resource management, financial management and production management. So I hope today's topic was descriptive enough. Stay tuned, stay healthy. Thank you.